crowd here at ringside. We are ready to go with a great crowd today for more USWA Championship Wrestling. Got a great show coming up. Kowabunga and Ken Wayne will be teamed up here in just a moment as we get things underway. Jeff Gaylord, the Missouri Tiger, will be along a little bit later on. Dirty White Boy will be here today. The Superstar and the King, Bill Dundee and Jerry Lawler, will be teamed up for tag team action later on today. And the USWA World Tag Team titles will be defended right here on USWA Championship Wrestling a little bit later on. Joey Maggs and Rex King will be in to defend the belts right here on television today. Bundy the Gorilla is back. Bundy, I want to make sure, are you the real Bundy the Gorilla today?
I swear from the bottom of my hairy heart, I'm the real Bundy the Gorilla, and I want those sideshow freaks to keep their hands off me.
All right, very good. Well, yeah, you watch yourself today. Don't want you tied up in the back anymore the way that happened last week. I can tell by the voice that is the real Bundy the Gorilla, the mascot who's with us here today. All right, we got a big show coming up. We'll be back in just a moment. We'll have that first match underway for you. The screen there, you were looking at the Twilight Zone. We had them here last week for the first time, and as we told you, we didn't know anything about them, including their names, but now we do. Their names are Nebula and Quasar. Here come their opponents right here. Ken Wayne, he wears the U.S. Junior Heavyweight title around his waist. He's in here today in tag team action with his partner, Kowabunga, walking around the ring right now, greeting some of the fans, especially some of the younger fans there who wanted to shake hands with him. A little greeting for Bundy the Gorilla, and Kowabunga steps up onto the ring apron. Ken Wayne already in the ring. Nebula and Quasar over here in the corner of Twilight Zone. As soon as we get one apiece for these tag teams, we will be ready to go. Jerry Calhoun, the referee. This one's going to be a one-fall, 10-minute time limit match. And here we go. Ken Wayne starts for his team. It is Nebula starting for the Twilight Zone. Ken Wayne backs away. They were back in the turnbuckles. And Nebula is complaining to the referee. Oh, we got a complainer here. Tactics we've talked about before. Trying to get the referee looking at the opponent a little more closer. Ken Wayne says, no, I didn't pull on the mask. The fans back up Ken Wayne, of course. I didn't see him pull on the mask either. There's good look at Ken Wayne. And Nebula now up in the air. Ken Wayne body slams him right there in the middle of the ring. Nebula on his feet and immediately starts screaming, hey, pull it tight. Crowd says, hey, quit complaining and wrestle, for heaven's sakes. Whoa, Ken Wayne, left arm twisted a couple of times. He hooks Nebula, nice move as he pops him down to the mat. Grabs the left arm, he doesn't put a bar on it, but he hangs on to it. Ken Wayne back to the corner. And much to the delight of many of the fans, especially the younger ones, here is Kowabunga. First official look at him in the match. He came in here a few weeks ago, and boy, a couple of people, Ken Wayne, his partner for one of them, kind of made fun, and they saw him wrestle a couple of times and said, hey, I respect him. He can move. He can wrestle. Kowabunga has Quasar back onto the rope. I don't know if tickling is legal or not, but that's what he did anyway. Kowabunga flipping Quasar around the ring. Quasar and Nebula, the Twilight Zone. Hey, was not pulling his tights. I tell you, this Nebula, the Twilight Zone, is pleading his case all the way here. Drop. And all of a sudden, Nebula saw that and is not sure he wants to take the tag from his partner, so he walks down the ring, turns his back, and refused the tag. Can you believe it? Tag team partner's here. Yeah, he says, yeah, come on, let's hear it for the Twilight Zone, he says. His partner says, hey, come on, how about a tag? Well, finally he gets a tag, and Nebula, who started this match, will be coming back in. But he only accepted that tag after Kowabunga went over to the corner and tagged Ken Wayne. Ken Wayne back in. Again, hit with a fist, I think. Comes out of the turnbuckles there, and Nebula dropped him. Twilight Zone. Really working hard here to try to get something going against Ken Wayne and Kowabunga. Here's Kowabunga back in. He grabs Quasar. Clothesline off the ropes. He's over to the corner and flips the other one in there. So now he's working on Nebula while Ken Wayne has Quasar tied up. All four of them in the ring. Ken Wayne drops him down with that back suplex. Count of three, and this one is history. And it goes into the books as a victory for Ken Wayne and Kowabunga. They got themselves a win in 3 minutes, 25 seconds of action. Oh, and the Twilight Zone, not happy about it, especially Nebula, the taller of the two. There comes downtown Bruno and Jeff Gaylord.
Sir, free Ricky P. Yeah. Let me tell you something. Jeff and myself stand around, watch the matches in the back on a monitor and so forth, and nothing makes us madder and more disgusted than seeing this idiot in his turtle suit, Kowabunga, the Karate Turtle. Now, we've been in this profession for a long time. We've been at the very top, and we know what it's like to be at the very bottom. You know, underneath that very bottom, underneath that rock, that's where Kowabunga crawled up from, because he's the most disgusting thing that I've ever seen in all my years in the professional wrestling business. That makes me mad. So the Missouri Tiger, Jeff Gaylord, is going to tear that punk apart and show him why you don't mess around with our profession. You don't mess around with downtown Bruno, and you don't mess around with the Missouri Tiger. It's like Mama says, it bees that way sometimes. Tell him, Jeff.
Let me tell you something. You know what kind of training and hours in the gym and blood, sweat, and tears it takes to get a body like this?
Look at that.
Take a look at this body.
Look at that.
Look at this. Look at that. And you think some idiot in a frog suit is going to come over here and think he can be a wrestler? Well, that's idiotic. I'll tell you what, I'm sick and tired of punks like him coming in here thinking they can do something in a frog suit. And it's going to be my personal vendetta to knock that idiot in that frog suit out of wrestling. Because we are mad. We are real mad.
Let's get out of here.
Because this is what a champion is all about.
That's it, baby. Let's get out of here.
Yeah, it's a good idea. Get out of here. It's not a frog suit, it's a turtle suit. And we'll see if you can beat him in the ring. How about in a match there rather than out here talking about it? We'll take a break, and Gaylord will be back in a match in just a moment. Jordan has just been escorted to the ring by one of the USWA ring girls. He waits in the ring right now as referee Jerry Calhoun steps up onto the ring apron. And another USWA ring girl leading the way as downtown Bruno and the Missouri Tiger Jeff Gaylord head to the ring. Gaylord climbs through the ropes, and we are just about set to go. One fall, 10-minute time limit match. Ben Jordan goes against Jeff Gaylord. Downtown Bruno has stolen my microphone here.
I sure have. And Dave, I'm pretty upset right now because there's no chair here for me, and you knew it was my time to come out here. There should be a chair here for me at all times.
We were hoping you would take the hint and see that there was no chair here.
Dave, I don't take any hints, brother, because this is my time. Let me tell you something. Jeff Gaylord is the biggest, the strongest, the meanest man in professional wrestling. By far, bar none. I train him every day in the gym personally. I get him through his workouts, and I do my own press curls and running. You know what I'm talking about?
You do presses, curls, and running?
Yes, sir. I press my suit, I curl my hair, and I run late every day.
I can believe that, yeah.
But, just a little bit of humor there, a little bit of downtown humor, if you know what I mean. Oh, very funny, Dave. But, Mr. Gaylord bench presses, get this, 897 pounds. He does reps with that. 10 times did 897 pounds the other day.
897 pounds is almost half a ton.
I know it. Can you imagine that? He did it all by himself. I didn't have to help him at all. I got rid of that loser he was running around with because he was dragging him down. It's just Gaylord now. Gaylord and downtown Bruno.
That's
and I'm going to tell you something else. How about curls, Dave? Can you imagine this? He curls two Volkswagens. What he does, he takes the Volkswagen and he turns it sideways. And he takes the other Volkswagen and he turns that sideways. And he curls two Volkswagens. And the reason I'm telling you all this, our secret training regimen, so that idiot goofball jerk Kowabunga will pay attention and understand exactly what he's dealing with, exactly what he's messing with when he messes with the Missouri Tiger and when he messes with downtown Bruno. Because that is the strongest and meanest man in professional wrestling right there.
Well, Gaylord
just about
broke Ben Jordan's neck when he threw him onto the top rope, and Jordan snapped back into the ring. Referee Jerry Calhoun there to help. Come on, Bruno, stay out of it now. Don't go over there kicking on him. Gaylord kicks Ben out of the ring. Oh, wonderful. Downtown Bruno takes his shoe off and nails Ben Jordan. This match is over. Bruno jumping Ben Jordan, referee trying to back him up. Oh, Bruno almost shoved the referee down. That'd be a $1,000 fine right there. Talk about a real low-class individual. You're looking at downtown Bruno. Now, here comes Kowabunga out to help out. Kowabunga facing Jeff Gaylord. Gaylord trying to move or two, but both of them blocked so far by Kowabunga. Well, Kowabunga gets him off his feet down on the floor, and now Gaylord decides, yeah, let me at him, he says, but I don't see him climbing up on the rope. I see him backing up is what it looks like, as Kowabunga is just waiting right there in the middle of the ring, and Bruno is saying, come on, hey, maybe we better get out of here, Jeff. Gaylord won the match. The time on it was 2 minutes 15 seconds, 2:15. Jeff Gaylord gets the win over Ben Jordan. But then he and Bruno start jumping all over Kowabunga. See, we get him over here maybe just for a brief interview. Kowabunga, thank goodness, came out and helped out a little bit. And finally got Bruno and Jeff Gaylord out of here. Kowabunga, he's made quite an impression since he's been in the area here. And I think, Kowabunga, you have made quite an impression just now on Mr. Jeff Gaylord.
That's bogus, dude. That ain't no way to treat Ben Jordan. He's an up-and-coming wrestler, and that's no way to treat him. Jeff Gaylord, you're a bogus wrestler. You're not a totally radical, awesome, bodacious wrestler like Kowabunga, Jerry the King Lawler, and the rest of us guys around here. So I'm taking you down to the sewers, my friend. I'm putting you down in that water. I'm making you back up. I'm throwing you in that ring. And I'm going to beat you up turtle style, my friend. I'm going to send you back down to the sewers. It's time, baby. Kowabunga is back. Kowabunga is here to stay. And Karate Turtle will run rampant on Jeff Gaylord. And downtown Bruno? Give me a break, dude.
Kowabunga, he'll be facing Jeff Gaylord, and he'll have to face Bruno in the corner too. Championship wrestling will continue in a moment. Joining me right here is a special announcer at the Mid-South Coliseum on Monday nights, and you always fill us in on the special promotions, which have been numerous in this tremendous summer, and the crowds have been great recently. So what's coming up this week?
Well, Dave, this week it's Super SummerSlam Fest 1990 at the Mid-South Coliseum. In addition to 8 big matches, we're going to have cash and surprise prizes to give away all Monday night. This Monday night, special Hammer Time promotion at the Mid-South Coliseum during intermission. We're going to give away MC Hammer cassettes and LPs to the fans. We're going to have special bikini modeling by the USWA ring girls. You won't want to miss this Monday night. Also, prizes and McDonald's food certificates passed out to the crowd by Bundy the Gorilla. Giving away music from our fans and our friends over at Pop Tunes this Monday night. Also, if you'd like to book a wrestler for your charity or organization, you can do so by calling 375-4044 Championship Marketing to book your favorite wrestler or USWA ring girl.
Yeah,
available for appearances.
We get calls all the time, say, hey, how do I get so-and-so to make an appearance here? Well, that's the number right here on your screen.
Area code 375.
Mm-hmm. Area code 901 if you're outside of West Tennessee. Area code 901-375-4044. That's
right. That's exactly it. Super Summer Slam Fest this Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum. Make your plans early to be there.
And listen to this card. Opening match, 8 o'clock is when it all begins Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum for Summer Slam Fest. Ken Wayne will be going against the Galaxian. Now, Ken Wayne used to be a Galaxian, so these are former partners going at each other in the opening match Monday night at the Coliseum. Following that, Kowabunga against Jeff Gaylord. Well, you've just seen that these guys don't like each other a whole lot. And the main problem there is Jeff Gaylord. He has taken it as a personal vendetta to go after Kowabunga. He takes offense at the Kowabunga, the costume he wears or something like that. And Gaylord and Downtown Bruno will be there against Kowabunga Monday night. Then, USWA tag titles on the line. Now, we're going to have a championship match a little bit later on here today, but Rex King and Joey Maggs, the champions, will have the belts on the line against Rod Price and Reggie B. Fine. Now, Rod Price, Wayne, you remember Devastation, who was unmasked by Jeff Jarrett. Well, that's Rod Price. This guy is huge, and he is going to have, and this is very interesting, Reggie B. Fine in wrestling tights as his partner in a USWA World Tag Team title match. All right. Jeff Jarrett goes against Don Harris. Bad blood between these two. They've been involved in tag team matches against each other, but this time, one against one. Jeff Jarrett against Don Harris. Unified world title match. The Snowman will have the belt on the line against Primetime Brian Lee. Primetime Brian Lee, quite an athlete. We don't like the way he breaks the rules all the time, but he certainly has the capability of becoming the next unified world champion. And see Monday night as that belt is on the line as the Snowman will bring it in against Brian Lee. Then, special challenge match. We'll have more to say about this one a little bit later on. Eddie Marlin goes against Sam Lowe in the ring in a special challenge match. Then a back alley street brawl. We've had a back alley street brawl last week between Tessa and Dirty White Girl. This one is going to be in a cage. Now remember, back alley street brawl rules means that they are there in street clothes, and it's a modesty thing is the reason you lose when you have to retire because articles of your clothing are being removed by your opponent.
Disrobed, yeah.
That's exactly right. Cage match then. 12-foot high cage is going to be around the ring, and you will have the King, Jerry Lawler, Superstar, Bill Dundee, Universal Heartthrob, Austin Idol, all back together against Gilbert, Eddie Gilbert, John Tatum, and Dirty White Boy. This time, though, it's going to be in a cage 12 feet high all the way around the ring. What a night, Monday night, at the Mid-South Coliseum beginning at 8 o'clock. Now, last week, Wayne, you can verify there were ticket lines out there. In order to cut down your wait in a line, it might be a good idea for you to pick up your tickets in advance. You can do that at the Coliseum until 4 o'clock today and all day on Monday. And also, tickets are available at all the Ticketmaster locations. Have a good one down there Monday night. Looks like it's going to be a great card.
It is Super SummerSlam Fest 1990 and a special Hammer Time promotion that you don't want to miss this Monday night.
All right. Very good. Should be a nice, nice night Monday night at the Mid-South Cox. Well, before we break, let's see what Reggie B. Fine. I want to find out about Reggie B. Fine. You're supposed to be in wrestling tights Monday night as part of a tag team.
Look, man, I'm 235 pounds of pure steel and sex appeal, you understand? You think I'm scared of these punks that run around here? I ain't got no business being no manager, no way. See, managers don't get no respect. So I'm going inside this square circle, baby, and bust some heads. I'm talking about all these chumps. I'm getting every belt in the organization, baby. I mean, every belt we got, Reggie B. Fine gonna hold it. And I got a real pot. Shut up, you low budgets, while I'm talking. I'm gonna get every belt in the organization, baby. And you know what? I'm gonna be the next world heavyweight champion.
Well, we'll see. You'll have your opportunity to begin Monday night at the Coliseum going for the USWA World Tag Team titles. That's Reggie B. Fine. We'll be back here with more USWA action.
Watching WMC TV 5, Memphis.
Beat the heat.
On TV 5.
What a thunderstorm!
Yeah!
scary.
Hey, don't worry, guys. Just remember, if you're caught outside, never take shelter under a single tree. Don't stand out in the open. And if possible, ride out the storm in a nice, sturdy building.
Stay cool this summer with Snowbird. Brought to you by TV5 and Baptist Memorial Hospital. Just dial doctors.
Dave Brown back here at ringside. If you joined us just now at our regular time, we've already been on the air for a half hour. So far, Kowabunga and Ken Wayne have won their match, and Jeff Gaylord has defeated Ben Jordan. We're on a half hour early today due to an NFL game, which comes on at 12 noon, but we still got 1 hour of USWA action to go, so stay with us here. We want to show you right now some videotape, which occurred at the Memphis Mid-South Coliseum last week. It was a six-man tag team match, and this turned out to be a wild one, as expected. On one side, you had Eddie Gilbert, the Dirty White Boy, and Hollywood John Tatum going against the King, Jerry Lawler, superstar Bill Dundee, and the Universal heartthrob Austin Idol. Take a look at what happened.
To the handcuffs. He just hit Eddie Marlin with a chain several times in the back of the head. That's the Dirty White Boy. Comes in there, breaks the figure four. His patented move as Tony Anthony takes his boot off. Nails Idol right in the top of the head. Lawler has Gilbert over in the corner, but not for long, as Tony Anthony, and there are the boots, just levels everybody as Tom Burton is over there unhandcuffing Sam Lowe.
Well, I thought Idol had him. He had Tatum in that Las Vegas leg lock until Anthony got his boot off. Tatum kicking Bill Dundee out of the ring. White Boy has, man, White Boy has a chain you could put around your tire. Nails Idol with it.
As Eddie Marlin's been handcuffed to the turnbuckle by Sam Lowe and Tom Burton. Burton in there pounding on Dundee now. Eddie Gilbert handcuffed, helpless over there. Look at this. Both men on both sides just drove Idol's head right down into the mat. He's already bleeding. As Sam Lowe holding Lawler over there at bay as Tony Anthony with that chain working him over. Referee Jerry Calhoun calling for the bell to be rung, saying that Austin Idol cannot continue. The winners of the match, unfortunately, Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, Hollywood John Tatum, and the Dirty White Boy.
Well, they jammed Idol's neck big time with that spike pile driver. All three of them. Referee has called for the bell and called for the stretcher. Joey Maggs out here. They're trying to get Idol out. Rex King are out here to get Idol out, and they need to get him out bad. He is hurt. They need to get Idol to a doctor and check on that neck. Eddie Gilbert yelling for the stretcher. Joey Maggs has the stretcher. He and Rex King are going to try to get Idol out of here. Man, he is a mess.
Idol in bad shape, has been pile driven, has been hit with that chain. Eddie Marlin finally being unhandcuffed over there. Oh no! Eddie Marlin just been attacked by Tom Burton and Sam Lowe. Tom Burton and Sam Lowe over there working over Eddie Marlin. As the White Boy and Eddie Gilbert continue to pound on Lawler, but Gilbert in there with a chain just puts Calhoun down to the canvas.
Well, I'm sure there are going to be some fines involved for a lot of people in this matchup. That's officially over. They've already put Austin Idol out on a stretcher, but it looks like they intend to do the same to the entire team. They want to put Dundee and Lawler in the hospital. Gilbert holding Dundee up. Dirty White Boy still with that chain, fires away on him. They're saying, hey, we're going to pile drive these two guys. Hey, look, guys, this match is over with. You know, I don't know if there's anybody much left back in the dressing room to help them. Max and King were here, but they were trying to get Idol out to a doctor out on the stretcher.
Tony Anthony all over Lawler. Yeah, like someone's coming out. Idol's back out. A bloody mess with a baseball bat. Just levels the dirty white boy right in the head with it. Levels John Tatum. And Eddie Gilbert and Tom Burton across the back of the deck with that baseball bat. Idol in here, serious business. As Lawler throws Sam Lowe up in there. They're holding Sam up. Lawler nails him with a chain. Sam Lowe goes down hard. Lawler up to his feet. Dundee, Idol with that bat right across the top of the head of Sam Lowe.
He just slams Tom Burton in the head and stomach with a baseball bat.
The Universal Heartthrob made it back with a baseball bat and cleared the ring out.
Well, you saw it right there, and the rematch is going to occur with a 12-foot cage all around the ring. Here comes Eddie Marlin. Boy, Eddie, you know, steamed at what's going on there with Sam Lowe.
I won't take but a minute of your time, but I want Sam Lowe to come out here just for a second. Sam Lowe, if you're back there, come out here just for a minute.
Here he is.
Come up here just for a second. Come on. Sam Lowe, the first thing I want to say, you notice on the card, Tom Burton's not booked on the card, and he won't be booked on the card because he has been suspended. I was handcuffed to you, and he came out and sucker-punched me. And then you started putting the boots to me. Let me tell you something. I was climbing in the ring, wrestling the guys, wrestling all of them when you were still in diapers. I'm an old man. You're a young punk. And I started in the business. If I'd had the attitude that you got today, I'd have never made it this far because some of the old-timers would slap the taste right out of my mouth. Now, I want to make one thing clear to you. We was handcuffed last week. This week, you're going to get in the ring. When Tom Burton knocked me down, you put the boots to me. And I want you to see how it feels for somebody over you putting the boots to you while you're down. Because believe me, when I put this upside your head, you're going to be down. But I'm going to put the boots to you. Now, you can depend on that.
All right, come on. Eddie Gilbert coming out here. Eddie, I think the situation's settled.
Oh, no, I don't think so. You know, Mr. Eddie Marlin, you can stand out here and tell us how old you are. We know how old you are. All you got to do is look at your hair.
Well,
look
let me
at
tell
your...
you one other thing.
What?
It just happens to be that Monday night is my birthday. I'll be 60 years old, young man, and I'm going to give myself a birthday present by putting the boots to his fanny.
Okay, I tell you what. Before you put the boots to his fanny, will you please do me a big favor? Will you please sign a release saying that when you get in the ring and you go, that you won't hold me and Sam Lowe responsible because that kind of stigma on this poor young man's head could affect him the rest of his life.
Thing.
What?
What you need to do, somebody needs to do for you,
yeah,
is turn you over their knee and spank your behind like your daddy should have done.
Well, just make one thing sure and clear that he makes sure me and Sam Lowe are his beneficiaries on his life insurance policy, okay, Dave Brown?
I think maybe you just better show up and look out. Eddie Marlin's been in some tough matches over the years. We'll see Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum. We'll take a break. Be back here in just a moment. Keith Haynes is in the ring right now with the referee Jerry Calhoun. His opponent should be headed to the ring very, very shortly. I hear the music. And here comes
the Dirty White Girl leading Dirty White Boy up to the ring. Single match coming up here against Keith Haynes. Keith with his work definitely cut out for him today, going against one of the most rugged wrestlers anywhere around, Tony Anthony, the Dirty White Boy. Tony steps through the ring ropes. Jerry Calhoun says, ring it, let's go. Keith Haynes actually probably has a slight weight advantage over Dirty White Boy, but not by much. Tony Anthony has the height advantage, that's for sure, and also I think you'd have to concede him the meanness advantage. Ooh, forearm right in the face he caught Keith Haynes coming off the rope. Picks him up by the hair, a headbutt, and Haynes is immediately in trouble.
match less than 30 seconds old. And Tony Anthony is in complete control. Over the back. Well, that's a tough thing to do, to get a man that size off his feet like that. But Tony Anthony does it, and Keith Haynes finds himself lying on the mat until Tony Anthony picks him up and takes him over to the rope. Anthony was using that middle rope to choke him. Haynes tied up in the ropes, and Anthony continues to pound on him and work on him over there. Referee Jerry Calhoun's over now, trying to get him untied, and does. Tony Anthony right there to grab him, flip him back out into the center of the ring. Anthony brings the knee up. That was a legal move. Referee saw that one and said, yeah, it was okay. Tony Anthony with the chop and the choke, followed by another chop. There's a flip. Anthony drops down with a lower leg. Little hair pulling by the dirty white boy. Anthony power slams him down to the mat. Does he go for the count of three? Nope, not yet. He walks away. Backs halfway across the ring, now into a corner. Gets a running start, drops down with the upper arm. He goes for the cover now. One, two, it's over. Dirty White Boy in control of the entire match. 2 minutes, 4 seconds the time, and Dirty White Boy has just taken a victory from Keith Haynes here as he climbs through the ropes, out of the ring, and the congratulations of Dirty White Girl go to the victor in 2 minutes, 4 seconds, Tony Anthony. Doug, just a minute, you have a match coming up this week with Tessa.
I'm excited about it. I don't know about you. First time ever. Back alley street fight in a cage with two girls. I'm excited. I'm thrilled to death. I don't think I've ever seen one. Have you ever seen one?
No, I haven't.
It's first time for you too.
In a cage, that's right.
Well, won't you come down by your ringside seat, baby, and watch it all.
I noticed you had a towel there for safety sake last week too, right?
No. See, the towel was so I could come down and cover this pretty thing's eyes up, so she wouldn't have to look at that old beast. Lord, nothing happening individual. Tessa, I mean, you know, come on, take a good look at that wide load, brother. That's enough to puke a buzzard off a gut wagon.
Well, Monday night, it's going to be in the cage at the Coliseum, and a 12-foot cage all around.
Hey, Tessa, you listen up. You nothing happening individual. We're in a cage, and I know for a fact that you have never been around one or ever saw one in your life. Well, I have. I've seen the instinct of this man right here with blood gushing out of his head, all wild-eyed and trying to put another man through a cage. Well, that's the instinct I'm going to have on you. So you listen up for a moment and quit putting that bleach in your head and frying that brain of yours up. I'm coming with one thing in mind, and that's to hurt you, and it's beyond the point of snatching clothes. Snatching hair and ripping clothes off, which I'm sure there will be some of that. You check yourself into a local hospital, because when it's all over, said and done with, that's where you're going. You're going to be stretched, and I'm going to walk out the winner.
I wonder if that bleach blonde bimbo heard that.
Huh? Whoa. Tessa out, and Dundee right behind her. To keep Tessa from getting to the Dirty White Girl, Dirty White Boy has got her in tow, and they head out of here. And there is Tessa. Obviously, you heard what she said.
Let me tell you something, Dirty White Girl. You can stand out here and call me all the names you want to. But I'll tell you what, every time that I have gotten the best of you, someone has interfered. Now, there isn't going to be any help for you next week, because we're in the cage. It's just me and you. And then you're going to have to show all these people just what kind of woman you think that you are. And let me tell you this much. I'm prettier than you. I'm bigger than you. And I'm smarter than you. And not only that, I can outsmart you in anything.
Well, Dirty White Girl came running back out here after Tessa this time, but a Dirty White Boy caught her just in time. And John D has Tessa until once again Dirty White Boy has taken Dirty White Girl out of the area. Look out, there's Tessa going after her. Dundee still got a hold of her. And I think the interview is over. It's coming up this week, and it'll be in that 12-foot cage, back alley, street rules in effect. Back with more very shortly. Take another look at the Mid-South Coliseum card this Monday night. Summer Slam Fest 90, it's going to be. 8 o'clock is when it starts. Cash and prize giveaway down there. Special MC Hammer Time promotion during intermission. Bikini modeling by the USWA Ring Girls. Bundy will have the family section, be giving out the McDonald's gift certificates there. And also music tapes from Pop Tunes. It's all Monday night. 8 o'clock is when it begins at the Coliseum. Opening match of the night will be Ken Wayne going against the Galaxian. And again, Ken Wayne used to be a Galaxian. Two former partners will be going at each other in what should be a terrific opening match at the Coliseum this week. Kowabunga goes against Jeff Gaylord. These two have been going at each other for several weeks now. For some reason, Gaylord has turned this into a personal thing as he is going after Kowabunga, says he wants to take the mask off and rip the uniform to shreds. Kowabunga against Jeff Gaylord in a single match Monday night. USWA tag titles on the line as champions Rex King and Joey Maggs put him on the line against Big Rod Price, who used to be Devastation. He was unmasked by Jeff Jarrett and really huge, and he will be teamed with, believe it or not, Reggie B. Fine. Now, Reggie B. Fine, I don't want to make fun because he is a big guy. I think he's 235 or something like that. He's big, and he's capable as far as size goes. Remains to be seen how he and Rod and if they can take the world title. Jeff Jarrett will be going against Don Harris. These two, as we said earlier, have faced each other in tag matches. This time it's going to be in a single match, Jeff against Don Harris in the ring. Unified world title on the line. Primetime Brian Lee will challenge for the belt held by the Snowman. Following that, a special challenge match. You heard a little bit about this just a moment ago. Eddie Marlin says... Eddie says he's an old man, but he says he can still beat Sam Lowe, and just like the old-timers would have done him if he had been a smart aleck punk like that when he was coming into the wrestling business years ago. Eddie Marlin against Sam Lowe in the ring in the special challenge. Back alley street brawl. They will be in a cage, and one thing Tony Anthony said, I think this may be the first time around here anyway that there's ever been a back alley street brawl with two women in a cage. Tessa against Dirty White Girl. That one right there, believe me, worth the price of admission by itself. Cage match for the main event of the night, though. The cage is 12 feet high. Lawler, Dundee, and Idol all back together and all going against Eddie Gilbert, John Tatum, and Dirty White Boy. Six-man tag team action in a 12-foot cage Monday night. Don't forget all the special promotions coming up. 8 o'clock is the time it all begins. There you see some of the things that are be going on. And the tickets are available at the Coliseum up to 4 o'clock today, all day Monday, and at all Ticketmaster locations. Bill?
That's right, Dave. Now, Jerry Lawler and Bill Dundee's been around here a long time, brother, and have had all kinds of matches, from scaffold matches to you name it, we've been in it. But this is the first time in my career I've ever seen two women get into a cage and start dressed and end up any way they want. And that's the way we want it, White Girl, because like Tessa said, every time she got to beat you up, somebody run in and stopped it. Well, there's no stop that Monday night. It's going to be Tessa getting rid of you, and then you'll be so embarrassed you won't come back no more, and that'll suit us just fine. And then it's another cage match with a heartthrob, the king, and the superstar. And there ain't no three tougher men walking the face of God's green earth than us. And yeah, I know what you're saying. Yeah, it's a disadvantage because they got Dundee, that little runt. Well, it's all been said about me before, punk. And I'm still here. And I'm gunning for you, White Boy. I don't care about them other two because Jerry Lawler and Austin Idol will take care of them. Tess is already going to have taken care of that little hussy you run around with. And I'm taking care of you, bud. So you zoom in on this face and you take a good look at it. Because this is the face that's putting you out of professional wrestling, Jack. You're not sure you're emulating me no more, nor Tessa. White Girl's going to be gone, and I'm taking care of you in the cage match. As sure as my name's Bill Superstar Dundee, then you'll both be out of here, Jack.
All right, your partner, one of them, Jerry Lawler.
All I want to say, I'll keep it short and I'll keep it sweet. A cage match says it all. Every week that we've wrestled these jerks, just the same situation as Tessa has had with the Dirty White Girl, somebody seems to interfere. We've even had to handcuff Tom Burton. We've tried everything to keep some kind of interference out of the match.
One week it's Tatum. The next week, last week, it's Tom Burton comes from the back. Well, I don't know if you heard what Eddie Marlin said out here a while ago, but there is no more Tom Burton. One half of the Dirty White Boys has been suspended, so he's not even going to be allowed in the Coliseum. He's out of town. We don't have to worry about him, and we wouldn't have to anyway because that 12-foot-high steel cage is going to keep everybody out, and more importantly, it's going to keep everybody in. So, Eddie Gilbert, you can run out here and run your little mouth and make your little jokes and fall down and have your phony little heart attacks. Well, let me tell you something. Monday night, when we get our hands on you, you may be having one of those heart attacks for real, pal, because I promise you, when the king and the superstar and the universal heartthrob get three jerks like you inside a cage, it's not going to be a pretty sight. I can promise you this. Eddie Gilbert, you and that punk Sam Lowe, I promise you, when Monday night's over with, your own mothers are not going to recognize you. Now, Austin Idol's got a few words that he wants to say. They took a camera in. They talked to him right after the match last week. This may not be a pretty sight, but Eddie Gilbert, Dirty White Boy, and John Tatum, you're going to get a chance to look into your future right now. And there's some words from Austin Idol, brother.
Right now, we want to get back to you real quick, right after the match that just took place at the Coliseum. Want to get a few comments from the heartthrob, Austin Idol. Austin.
You want words from me? You want words from me, mister? Here's words. Get out of my sight, you punk. Let me lay something on you. A lot of people in Memphis hate my guts, and they got reason. But there's a lot of people out there that love Austin Idol. But I'll tell you one thing about them. All of them know one thing. I'm a big, bad dude with a nasty attitude. And Eddie Marlin has just given me the word, Jack. And you know what he told me? One word! And it was my word. It was cage. C-A-G. Cage. I know how to spell it, and I know what to do when I get in it. You see, this Louisville slugger, Eastern slugger, ceramic slugger, I don't care what slugger it is, it ain't the bat. It's the dude who's holding the bat. And you're looking at Jose Canseco right here. Jose Canseco never swung a bat like I'm going to swing one Monday night. And I can promise you one thing. And I don't care if you're black as the ace of spades. I don't care if you're white. I don't care if you're red. I don't care if you're yellow. I don't care if you're green. If you'd like to see red, like you're looking at my face right here. This was just enough to crank me up, Jack. Then on Monday night, you tell your women, you tell your children, you tell your sugar daddies, you tell your boyfriends, you tell your mistresses, you tell your husbands, you tell your wives, the mailman, the priest, the preacher. I don't care who you tell. You tell them one thing. There's going to be a butt-kicking dude with a bad attitude inside a steel cage Monday night, and it's going to be me.
12-foot cage surrounds the ring. It'll be Lawler, Dundee, and Idol all together Monday night. Here's a special look at the Universal Heartthrob. Out here, Dirty White Boy, Dirty White Girl, and Eddie Gilbert, who looks like trying to take over the
Eddie
desk
Gilbert
here.
You.
You're right.
You know, it sounds to me like that there's a lot of people coming out here, and all they want to do is whine and cry, like, oh, he hit me with this, this person run in, that person run in. Well, why don't you accept the cold, hard facts? You got beat up. You got beat right in the middle of the ring. Accept it. Be men. If I lose, I'm man enough to say, hey, I lost. I'll catch you another day down the road. But you lost. No, you want to bring it back in a steel cage. Well, that's fine and dandy, brother, because the last time that I was in a steel cage, I almost had to go to the police station for manslaughter because I like to beat the man half to death. Now, it don't matter who you get, who wants to step in that cage. I don't care if you want to bring 50 fans out of the arenas and put them in that cage. I'll personally stomp every one of them. So, boys, all you got to do is have enough intestinal fortitude to show up and crawl in that cage and listen to that real awesome sound. And that'll be the cage being locked. And then you'll know right then and there that you're locked in with the dirty white boy and Mr. Hot Stuff himself.
Dave Brown, this is a very serious day. I want to ask you first if you have a better suit than this, because the following morning after this cage match, you're going to need one because you're going to be attending three funerals. Let me say, you guys could come out here and tell everybody you've been around here a long time. Well, I'll tell you how long you've been around here. You've been around here too long. I want to tell you, since I was a little kid, I have waited for this match. I have waited to enter a steel cage with three names that are legends in this area. I'm not going to stand out here and I'm not going to say, oh, Tony Anthony and myself are scared of a cage match. No, I'm not going to say that. I want you guys to step in the ring face to face because I've assembled an army better than King Hussein of Iraq has. And when I step in the ring with you, I'm going to look across the cage and I'm going to be looking at Margaret Thatcher, Mikhail Gorbachev, and George Bush. And this king is going to take you down. And you know, he can always say, there's going to be blood pouring like wine. There's going to be too much. And it's all going to be theirs. Oh, I feel so good.
Well, supreme confidence as Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, Dirty White Boy Tony Anthony, and the Dirty White Girl head out, looking forward to the match which is coming up here. And I tell you what, it's going to be some kind of excitement there. We got some excitement coming up right here. We've got a tag team match scheduled right now, which involves Lawler and Dundee, the superstar and the king, climbing up on the ring apron right now, Keith Eric and Deuce Mason. Here they come, escorted by one of the USWA ring girls. There's Lawler, the king, just about to do battle in the ring with his partner, the superstar, who you see right there over on the right part of the screen. Jerry Calhoun, the referee. This one will be one fall, 10-minute time limit. USWA tag team title match will follow this one in just a few minutes. We've got plenty of action remaining here today. Glad you could join us. The robes, the crown, all handed out of the ring. Here we go. Bill Dundee starts against Keith Eric. A couple of guys that don't have great height, but both of them are battlers, let me tell you. I don't think Keith Eric ever stepped in a ring that he wasn't convinced in his own mind that he was going to win the match. He hasn't won that many of them, but still maintains the confidence. Lawler with a right fist. Jerry nailed him with it. He hit him with a doubled up fist, and Jerry Calhoun says, hey, come on, you can't do that. Eric staggered by it. You know, Lawler's faced Eric as a single before. I remember a couple of times when Eric has tried to jump Lawler way before the bell sounded, and maybe Lawler is just remembering that and paying it back a little bit. Oh, hey, look at that. Eric nailed him with the right fist. But he didn't have to wait long for Lawler to get even as Lawler smacked him right back with that right fist. Jerry Calhoun has said, keep the fist open. This is Deuce Mason in there now. Mason got a little too close to Lawler, and Lawler took his legs out from under him. Deuce Mason finds himself on his back right in the middle of the ring. A minute, 12 seconds gone in this match. One fall, 10 minutes, the overall time limit. Oh, the referee turned his back just for a moment, and Jerry Lawler proved that he can use moves that maybe we don't all approve of sometimes himself. Forces the left arm of Deuce Mason over, then shoves him down to the mat. He's near the corner, reaches back, tags Bill Dundee. Dundee in with a boot to the shoulder. left arm. Now Dundee wraps it up, puts a twist on it. Deuce Mason reverses it on him, and Dundee knocked it down. Yeah, he doubled the fist up. He and Lawler both have used the fist today. I think they're both still pretty steamed over that situation which occurred involving the baseball bat and their partner getting beat up. Count of two. And I think maybe they're looking forward to the rematch involving Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert and Dirty White Boy. Bill Dundee. Down behind Deuce Mason, rides him down to the mat. Nice move by Dundee as he hooked that arm back. Tag made by Dundee on Jerry Lawler. Lawler comes back in. Uh-oh. Wishbone time. Bruce Mason rolling around the ring in pain. Lawler nails him again with a fist, and again the referee steps in and says, hey, you can't use the fist. Keep it open. Mason able to make it over to the corner with great difficulty, but gets the tag on Keith Eric. 3.5 minutes gone. 10 minutes, the time limit of this match. Hey, what a move by Lawler. Proves he can move in that ring. They double up now on Keith Eric. Both of them nail him with their fist coming off the ropes there. Lawler now leaves, heads back out to the apron. Dundee sliding the boots off the side of Keith Eric's face. Walked across his forehead. And now, in the midsection, flat of the boot on the stomach. That was legal. I think Dundee maybe had ideas about another similar move that would not have been legal, but he didn't do it. Dundee, look at him go with those fists doubled up. And again, the referee warning him about it. As we said earlier, Lawler and Dundee both seem to have it cranked up an extra notch today. Well, Lawler with a smash off the middle rope. Counts one, two, three. Give Dundee an assist as he nailed Keith Eric, who was coming in to interfere in the situation. Dundee kept him out of it. Lawler was able to hold the three count, and in 4 minutes, 48 seconds, 4:48, it's a victory for Lawler and Dundee. Dundee with congratulations from the crowd as he leaves the wrestling area after the victory. Back with more, including the USWA World Tag Title match when we return.
Hey, if you're looking for USWA Championship wrestling around the territory, look no further than Jackson, Tennessee. 8 o'clock tomorrow night, live wrestling at the Broncos. All ages are welcome there. Lawler will be there. Jeff Jarrett, Dundee, a ladies match too. Tomorrow night, 8 o'clock in Jackson. Friday night, August 17th, Boonville, Mississippi. 8 o'clock is the time. City Park is the place. You'll see some of the folks that are going to be there. Tickets are available right now. That's Boonville, Mississippi, Friday night the 17th. Saturday, August 25th, Jonesboro, Arkansas. Championship Wrestling back in Jonesboro, Arkansas, at the Earl Bell Community Center on Church Street. You see the folks that will be there. The box office will be open that day at 3 o'clock for advanced ticket sales. That's on Saturday the 25th in Jonesboro. Friday, August 31st, Championship Wrestling will be in Kennett, Missouri. Back in the Boot Heel, American Legion Building is where it's going to be. USWA Wrestling will be coming back to town at 8 o'clock Friday night, August 31st, in Kennett, Missouri. Friday, September 7th, Forest City, Arkansas, at the Civic Center. Tickets are available right now. More details on this in later weeks. And coming soon, there will be USWA Wrestling live in Senatobia, Mississippi, in Ripley, Mississippi, and on September 2nd in Lexington, Tennessee. That is the action coming up. Speaking of action, we've got those tag team belts on the line when we come back.
All four men in the ring. Jarrett back up on Harris. Snowman continuing to fire away. Jarrett whips Harris through the ropes, misses with line. Here comes Don, misses with a flying cross body block. Goes outside the ring. Jared follows him. No man has Brian Lee. Slams him down to the mat.
We don't call it USWA Championship Wrestling for nothing. We've got USWA World Tag Team titles on the line right now in a championship match. By the way, there's been a recent rules change by the USWA Rules Committee, trying two out of three falls for tag team championship matches, but had some problems with that, especially with TV matches. One fall only.
This big gorilla you have is called Snowman, who's supposedly the world heavyweight champion. I want you to show a tape and show what primetime Brian Lee can do to a champion and show you who the real champion really is. Tell him, Bruno.
Here's your champion right there, primetime, baby.
Roll it.
Back of the head with that chain that Bruno just threw in there. Referee Jerry Calhoun gets into position. Count of one, count of two. It's a three count.
There you go, Dave Brown.
Well,
I'm
the
champion. Now, I should have the belt.
Well, you're going to have a chance because you've got a match coming up with a Snowman.
It beats that way sometimes.
Well, it ain't that way yet, but it may be as Brian Lee will get a chance at Snowman in an upcoming match here. Right now, here come the champions of the USWA. That's Rex King, his partner, Joey Mash, the holders of the World Tag Titles, and they're defending them right here on Championship Wrestling Today. Primetime Brian Lee and Don Harris. Boy, this is a tough tag team going against the world champions, and you add their manager, Downtown Bruno, in their corner, and that's an additional problem that the champions are going to have to watch out for here today.
They're not going to be champions for long.
Let me explain something to you, brother. I've managed a lot of tag teams over the years. You know that. I've had some of the greatest tag teams of all time. And right now, brother, I've got the greatest tag team that I've ever been associated with in all these years I've been around the USWA. This is the greatest tag team. Primetime Brian Lee and Don the Stomper Harris. And let me tell you something, brother. When you got Downtown Bruno in the corner, you know doggone good and well that a belt is in the near future, because I don't like going around without a belt and backseat of my car to look at for too long. And it's been too long. It's been way too long. So it's high time that prime time and the Stomper get the tag team championship, brother. Believe it.
Nice move by Joey Maggs as he kicks Mr. Harris in the back.
You better call him Mr. Harris.
Now, I didn't see a double team at all. Brian Lee over here complaining to Bruno. Bruno, maybe you better pay attention to what's going on, because I don't think it was exactly the way Brian Lee just described it to you. Don Harris steps back into the ring. Joey Maggs waits for it. Maggs and Rex King have really represented these USWA tag titles well. It didn't take them long to win them after they got together as a tag team, and they've been able to hang on to them and defend them against very rugged teams. And they're going against a tough team right here in Don Harris and primetime Brian Lee. There's a tag made by Don Harris. Don Harris, of course, formerly of the Bruise Brothers. He and his twin brother had a tag team together, but since he hooked up with primetime Brian Lee, they've been making some noise around the USWA, and they work their way into this title match. Rex King rolls over the back of Brian Lee and comes up with a great drop kick. Nice move, Rex King, as he takes Brian Lee down to the mat. Hangs onto that left arm. A flurry of activity there, but Rex King able to come out on top for the moment. Brian Lee off the rope. Oh, well, there's a nice move by Brian Lee, too. You got to give him credit. I saw it, Bruno. You don't have to say anything.
You call that the flying DDT leg drop. How do you like that? The flying DDT leg drop. That's my own personal version. I love it, baby.
I was going to say, sounds like something you made up there, Bruno. Rex King ducked out of the way, and Don Harris has just hit his partner, Brian Lee. The count. Oh, look at this. Rex King moves out of the way. And Don Harris has nailed Brian Lee for the second time, and we got trouble in the corner down here. Bruno, looks like your tag team may be falling apart on you, as Don Harris has accidentally nailed Brian Lee a couple of times, but Brian Lee is saying, look, we're trying to win the championship. We can't
don't worry, Dave. It's just a slight misunderstanding. A slight misunderstanding, as simple as that. But it's okay now. We're on our way. We got our goals set. We got our minds set. Our minds are one. 3-1, baby. And we're fixing to be the tag team champions because Mama said it bees that way sometimes.
Well,
look
Yeah, look at that. A jab, the point of the fingers to the throat, an illegal move by Brian Lee.
Oh, yeah, but you love it when Kowabunga does all that karate stuff, don't you? Well, wait till Jeff Gaylord gets hold of him. Then you won't have him to kick around anymore, see? Oh, Kowabunga does it, you call it great. When one of my guys here does it, you say it's illegal. You say it's a jab to the throat. It's illegal. Well, Dave, I don't go for that.
Well, you're absolutely wrong. When Kowabunga does it, he's usually using the flat of the hand surface, not the point of the fingers. Joey Maggs' head run into the boot of primetime Brian Lee. Brian Lee, oh, at a clothesline. Joey Maggs hits the mat. Brian Lee just threw him into the ring there.
Tell these people not to call me a weasel.
Well, our fans have the opportunity to call it like they see it sometimes, Bruno, is all I can say to you. Look at this. Don Harris outside with a right fist. Nails Joey Maggs, and there's a reason the fans call him that. He had his shoe off, and Bruno again involves himself in the action. Not content to let his tag team win it or lose it on their own merits, he has to interfere, try to tip the scales in their balance, in their favor. Joey Maggs. Snapped up into the air and down on the mat by Don Harris. Harris and Brian Lee, one of the tallest tag teams around. Watching it as they've got Joey Maggs back in the turnbuckles. Don Harris working on it now, upper arm as Maggs comes off the rope. Joey Maggs thrown through the rope down on the floor, and look out, there's Bruno along with primetime Brian Lee over here after him and throwing him into the table. This Bruno, I tell you. Joey Maggs back in the ring. Being worked on by Don Harris. Crowd yelling, weasel, weasel, at downtown Bruno. A right fist by Brian Lee. He doubled it up and smacked him. Joey Maggs trying to roll him down. He's got the shoulders on the mat. Counts at one, two, only a two count. Don Harris steps on his head as he came walking into the ring there. So Brian Lee avoids the pin thanks to Don Harris getting there in time to break it up. Brian Lee makes the tag, leaves Joey Maggs laying in the ring after dropping on him with the upper arm a couple of times. Don Harris saw that. He tries it, but Joey Maggs had moved out of the way. Joey's still a long way from the tag. He needs to get to the corner and tag Rex King. He does so. And here comes Rex King over the top rope. Nice side kick. Rex King using the right fist. He's got it doubled up. He's seen the other team use it, and he's using it too. Rex fires Don King into the rope. Jerry Calhoun, the referee's down on the floor trying to separate Joey Maggs and downtown Bruno. Meanwhile, Don Harris has nailed Rex King. Primetime Brian Lee rolls into the ring. He has a cover. Here's the referee. Count is one, two, three. Referee didn't see what happened. He was down on the floor trying to separate Maggs and Bruno.
I told you, downtown Bruno doesn't mess around with your brony. Downtown Bruno doesn't mess around with losers. Downtown Bruno is the manager of champions. And now I've got the USWA tag team champions of the whole wide world.
Downtown Bruno interferes, and his team walks out of here with the USWA tag titles. Joey Maggs and Rex King can't believe it, but they have lost the match. Jerry Calhoun is going that way. Let's take a quick break. We'll be back in just a moment.
Well, new champions as they walk out of here with the belts in their hands, much to the dismay of the now former champions, Rex King and Joey Maggs. Brian Lee and Don Harris with Downtown Bruno, new USWA Tag Team Champions. Haven't heard anything on the complaint there, so that's the way it is. New title holders. Hey, what a day we had today. Don't forget Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum. Going to be something else there. The cage around the ring for the back alley street brawl between Dirty White Girl and Tessa. That should be something to see, but not the last match of the night. Final match of the night. Again, in the cage, 12-foot-high cage, it'll be Lawler, Dundee, and Austin Idol involved in that match, which includes Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert and the Dirty White Boy. Should be a big night at the Coliseum beginning at 8 o'clock Monday night. We'll be looking for your regular time right here next week. Until then, I'm Dave Brown. So long, everybody.
The announcers on this program are selected and paid by parties other than this station, namely the promoters of USWA Championship Wrestling.
It's USWA Championship Wrestling Wednesday night at the Evansville Coliseum. A super spectacular card. The Galaxian meets Brickhouse Brown. Karate Turtle Kowabunga takes on the Missouri Tiger Jeff Gaylord. A USWA Tag Championship match. Southern Rocker Rex King and Hotshot Joey Bag take on Primetime Brian Lee and Don the Stomper Harris. In a special cage street brawl, for the first time ever, the girls will be in a cage. Tessa meets the Dirty White Girl. The main event is also a cage match. Jerry the King Lawler, Superstar Bill Dundee, and Jeff Jarrett team against Dirty White Boy Tony Anthony, Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, and Hollywood John Tatum. Wrestling fans in and around Cadiz, Kentucky, the USWA is coming your way this Thursday night, 8 o'clock at Trigg County High School. And for all our fans in southern Indiana and northern Kentucky, Evansville Wednesday night, the site of Super USWA Championship Wrestling at the Evansville Coliseum. Two special cage matches. Don't miss a minute of it Wednesday night.
You know, Primetime, Brian Lee and Don Harris, I don't know who you guys think you are. I don't know what kind of stuff you think you can get away with here in the USWA. You know, all you people are going to see right here later on in this show exactly the way the USWA tag team belts were stolen from us. Brian Lee and Don Harris and little Downtown Bruno, you didn't beat us. Our belts were stolen. Well, it doesn't matter. Wherever it's got to be, we're going to get our rematch. And when we do, the belts are going to come back home where they belong.
That's right. You know, Joey, I am sick and I am tired of trash like Brian Lee and Don Harris. Sticking her nose in, back jumping us from behind. Every time we have a match with these guys, you know, they throw the rule book right out the window. Well, fellas, I hope you guys have been training hard, working out, and saying your prayers. Because me and my partner, we've been in the gym every day, we've been working out, and we're coming to get you because we're getting those belts back where they belong.
Yeah. It's USWA Championship Wrestling Wednesday night at the Evansville Coliseum. A super spectacular card. The Galaxian meets Brickhouse Brown. Karate Turtle Kowabunga takes on the Missouri Tiger Jeff Gaylord. A USWA Tag Championship match. Southern Rocker Rex King and Hotshot Joey Bag take on Primetime Brian Lee and Don the Stomper Harris. In a special cage street brawl, for the first time ever, the girls will be in a cage. Tessa meets the Dirty White Girl. The main event is also a cage match. Jerry the King Lawler, Superstar Bill Dundee, and Jeff Jarrett team against Dirty White Boy Tony Anthony, Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, and Hollywood John Tatum. Wrestling fans in and around Cadiz, Kentucky, the USWA is coming your way this Thursday night, 8 o'clock at Trigg County High School. And for all our fans in southern Indiana and northern Kentucky, Evansville Wednesday night, the site of Super USWA Championship Wrestling at the Evansville Coliseum. Two special cage matches. Don't miss a minute of it Wednesday night. It's USWA Championship Wrestling Wednesday night at the Evansville Coliseum. A super spectacular card. The Galaxian meets Brickhouse Brown. Karate Turtle Kowabunga takes on the Missouri Tiger Jeff Gaylord. A USWA Tag Championship match. Southern Rocker Rex King and Hotshot Joey Bag take on Primetime Brian Lee and Don the Stomper Harris. In a special cage street brawl, for the first time ever, the girls will be in a cage. Tessa meets the Dirty White Girl. The main event is also a cage match. Jerry the King Lawler, Superstar Bill Dundee, and Jeff Jarrett team against Dirty White Boy Tony Anthony, Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, and Hollywood John Tatum. Wrestling fans in and around Cadiz, Kentucky, the USWA is coming your way this Thursday night, 8 o'clock at Trigg County High School. And for all our fans in southern Indiana and northern Kentucky, Evansville Wednesday night, the site of Super USWA Championship Wrestling at the Evansville Coliseum. Two special cage matches. Don't miss a minute of it Wednesday night.
Oh, this week, brother, two cage matches at the same time in the same building. Tessa will take care of that dirty little white girl, and I'm gunning for you, Tony Ampion. I got two partners that can take care of King Kong and Godzilla, if that's who you bring.
That's right. Well, you know, guys, when you have a cage match, it solves all the problems, because no one can get in and no one can get out. Gilbert and Anthony, you two guys, you three guys, you better get ready, because I guarantee you one thing, us three, and we're coming for one thing, and that's to take care of you three guys and put you out.
That's right. You know, you're looking at a dream team right here. Jeff Jarrett, Bill Superstar Dundee, and the King. You know, I guarantee you, I know three guys out there that are not going to be getting a lot of sleep between now and this match. Because like you said, when the cage goes up, 12-foot-high steel cage, that means nobody gets out. And more importantly, nobody gets in. You know that every week you've been saved by some outside interference. Well, not this week. It's going to boil down to whoever is the toughest. And I promise you this, you're going to find out that you're looking at them right now.
Team champions as a result of the match. Brian Lee and Don Harris get the victory over Joey Maggs and Rex King. You saw what happened. You saw downtown Bruno outside and all of those things. But anyway, new title holders, Lee and Don Harris. You know, as the match got started, Brian Lee was trying to show a videotape showing that he pinned the snowman. He didn't show you the whole thing. Maybe we could do that right now, kind of show you what really happened and all that.
All four men in the ring. Jared back up on Harris. Snowman continuing to fire away. Jared with fair through the ropes. Misses with the clothesline. Here comes Don. Misses with a flying cross body block. Goes outside the ring. Jared follows him. Snowman and Brian Lee slams him down to the mat.
Chain in behind Snowman's back as the Snowman picking him up. Brian Lee in from behind nails the Snowman right in the back of the head with that chain that Bruno just threw in there. Referee Jerry Calhoun gets into position. Count of one, count of two. It's a three count.
Well, you saw the pin, but you saw why. Once again, downtown Bruno gets involved in the whole thing. We wanted everybody to see the whole thing. That's what we did.
Kill him, Bruno. That's a real champion right there. See, what happened was, Snowman's the one that cheated, Dave. Why did he pick me up? I wasn't doing nothing.
Why were you in there?
He grabbed Bruno when he was down on the floor, picked him up in the ring. So what am I supposed to do? This is my manager. He paid for us, and I'm going to protect him. What else is a man supposed to do, right, Big Harris?
That big gorilla, he picked me up, was holding me up there, and he was going to throw me down and hurt me right in my head, Dave.
I have no sympathy, but that's enough about that match. We saw what happened when we saw the whole videotape. And again today, you interfere as they end up with these USWA tag titles around their waist. Thanks to some managerial interference.
Dave, that's not interference. The only person I was interfering with was you, because you do that commentary so goofy, I wanted to make sure it was done right. But, the thing is, I told you, I come out here week after week. I've had wrestlers that beat opponent after opponent, but you still seem to sell me just a little bit short, don't you? I've come around here for years. I told everybody exactly what I've been going to do, and I've done it. Now, I told you that Primetime Brian Lee and Don Harris were going to be the tag team champions of the whole wide world, and you wouldn't believe me, but guess what? Around the waist right now, I got the tag team championship belts of the USWA. And everybody in the world can see that Downtown Bruno is the manager. I've got the proof of it, of the greatest tag team in the world. They've got the belts. I've got the champions. It means we're going to make all that money. We're going to get all them ducats, baby. And walking up and down the street, whether it's Memphis, Tennessee, Nashville, Tennessee, Evansville, Indiana, Jackson, Tennessee, Louisville, Kentucky, it don't matter where we go in Arkansas, Mississippi. Everybody needs to come down and see the greatest tag team with the greatest manager, Dave. And remember something else, brother. Remember this. I did not interfere. I did not cheat, because I don't do that. That's a figment of your
overactive imagination, Dave Brown. I've never interfered. I've never cheated a day in my life. I don't have to, because look at these bookends right here. These two huge, massive, hulking brutes don't need a little small person like me to interfere. Yeah, they're 275 apiece. I'm only 210. So I don't need to interfere for these big guys like that. I sit on my chair. I tell those people to leave me alone, to get off our backs. And something else, Dave Brown, you need to keep in mind. I know you're a big instigator about all this. Tell these idiots around the Mid-South, Midwest, everywhere, that I am not a weasel. I am downtown good-looking Bruno with the biggest, the baddest, and the best-looking tag team that ever walked into the USWA day. Do you understand me?
I hear what you're saying. The fans are free to say what they want. You do have, for the time being, the USWA tag team champions. Now you got to defend them.
Oh, we're going to defend them. I don't care if it's Jerry Lawler and Bill Dundee. I don't care if it's Rex King and Joey Maggs wanting their big rematch. We don't care. We don't care who it is. If Dirty White Boy and Eddie Gilbert want to sign up and get in on a match for the title, they can do it. That's okay. We're not going to be paper champions. We're not going to be closet champions. Because the only way you can be somebody is to beat somebody. So bring them all down. Line up. The mountain was high, the valley was low, but we made it through the rain, and we kept ourselves protected. We made it through the rain, and we found ourselves respected by the others who got rained on too, and made it through, and we made it through. Hey, y'all, and power to the people.
So brother can't only manage, but he can also rap. You know what I'm saying?
You heard about the two live crew? This is the new live crew, banned in the USA, baby, because nobody wants to get in the ring with these guys. Yeah, free Ricky B. Oh, yeah, baby.
I've heard enough. Take your newly won USWA World Tag Champions and head on out of here. We'll be looking for you at the arenas around the territory.
We'll be there.
But before we go, there's three words to describe this team. Fab, you, lust. Look for us, baby. We're everywhere.
We're out of time. Thanks to Bruno and the brand new USWA World Tag Team Champions. There'll be more next week. We hope you'll join us. Until then, I'm Dave Brown. So long, everybody.
The announcers on this program are selected and paid by parties other than this station, namely the promoters of USWA Championship Wrestling.